Hey everyone, welcome to homeschool and welcome back to class 11 chemistry. We have already started this organic chemistry, very very important and very very interesting topic of entire chemistry. So let us learn all the aspects of organic chemistry in a detailed way. So don't worry about the concept, I'm here to bring the concept clarity on all the topics of organic chemistry. In my previous video, I started with very very important topic, IUPAC nomenclature. We discussed nomenclature of saturated hydrocarbons with heavy branches. We worked with lots of questions and most of you have given correct answers for the homework questions. I'm very happy to see your answers in the comment section and keep commenting the answers. Every session I will end with few homework questions, so do watch the video till the end. And these homework questions are picked up from previous year's competitive question papers. So you can just check and analyze your knowledge, how much perfect you are with the concept. Fine, let us start the session with naming of unsaturated hydrocarbons today. So today we will discuss everything about naming of unsaturated hydrocarbons. So we know the word unsaturated, isn't it? Unsaturated in the sense you may have double bonds or you may have triple bonds between carbon atoms in a chain, between carbons in a chain, right? So such hydrocarbons are unsaturated hydrocarbons. So quite easy, few rules you have to keep in your mind and work with lots of questions so that you can name any compound, any unsaturated hydrocarbon easily. So let's talk about the rule number one that you need to remember. For naming any organic compound, first thing you will do is selecting a longest chain, right? So here also you need to select a longest chain, but that longest chain must have double bond or triple bond. Okay, so you need to select the longest chain in such a way that that longest chain should contain, it should contain double or triple bonds. Okay, so that is the necessary condition for selecting a longest chain. Remember this point, very very important. For example, suppose you have this compound with you, CH3 CH2 CH2 or CH double bond CH2, and here let me keep it as CH2 CH3, right? So this is the compound you have with you, and how do you select a longest chain here? What is the point says? Select a longest chain that should contain double or triple bonds, right? So here you have two options of selecting a longest chain. One is if you go straight, okay, or see, if you go straight, how many carbons you can cover? 1 2 3 4, you can actually cover 4 carbons. But if you go in this direction, how many carbons you can cover? 1 2 3 4 5 carbons you can cover, right? So what most people think is, oh, if I go this way I can cover 5 carbons. So that is what the major rule that we studied in a previous video while selecting a longest chain, right? So longest chain must contain maximum carbon atoms. Okay, so now you cannot apply that, right? So when you have a double or triple bonds in a compound, your longest chain must contain double or triple bonds. Instead of looking for maximum carbon atoms in a chain, look whether a longest chain has double or triple bonds. So this is important to understand, right? So now this is not the correct way of selecting a longest chain. So this is a correct way of selecting a longest chain. Okay, so this way your chain in this direction, when you go, you are covering maximum carbons, but still that is not the longest chain. This is a longest chain. Why? Because if you go in this direction, you are covering double bond. Double or triple bond is coming in a longest chain. That should be a necessary condition to keep in a mind for naming unsaturated hydrocarbons. Clear? Fine. So now let us learn rule number 2. Rule of numbering. Okay, so once you select a longest chain, then you will start numbering that carbons which are there in a longest chain, right? So how do you number them? Numbering is done in such a way that you can note it down all the points. Numbering is done in such a way that double bond containing, double or triple bond, double or triple bond containing carbon should get a least number. Containing carbon must get least or lowest number. Okay, so this must be the condition. So apply this rule here. Yes, you selected this chain as your longest chain because it included double bond. Now you have to number these carbons, right? So, do you number from left to right or right to left? I will start numbering from right to left and I will give number 1 for this carbon, number 2 for this carbon, this is 3 and this is 4. Why? Because when I number from right to left, my carbon having double bond is getting a least number. If you number from this side, 1, 2, 3. See, double bond containing carbon is having number 3. But if you number from this side, double bond containing carbon is having number 1. So, number 1 is a least number compared to number 3. So, I started numbering from this way. Clear? So, second rule is also very, very important. When you number carbon atoms, number in such a way that carbon having double or triple bond should get a least number, right? So we have done numbering also. Then remaining thing is writing its name, right? So how do you write its name? How do you write its name? Okay, so when you write a name, you will look for branch because this is like your prefix. Now this is a branch prefix. So its name you have to mention first. And this, what is this prefix CH2CH3? That means its name is ethyl. So this ethyl group has attached to which carbon? It has attached to carbon 2. So 2-ethyl. This is your prefix. And after prefix, you are writing a word root. Word root in the sense, you are mentioning the number of carbon atoms present in the longest chain. So, your longest chain had 4 carbons. So, I will write the word root bute. Okay. So, that's it. And now, I will mention the primary suffix. In my previous video, when we studied saturated hydrocarbons, we have used the primary suffix as ane. Right? Why? Because all carbons were having single bonds between them. But here, you have a double bond. So, you have to write primary suffix as ene. Okay. So, 2-ethyl-butene. See, you can just join and write butene. Or you can write in this way also. 2-ethyl-but-1-ene. You can mention exactly at which carbon double bond is there. And here many of them get a doubt that this double bond is there for carbon 1 and carbon 2 also. This double bond belongs to carbon 1 and carbon 2 also. So, should we mention it as but-1, 2-ene? No. Okay. At both carbon 1 and 2, double bond is there. But you will write the least number only. So, between 1 and 2, which is the least number? 1. So, we can write it as 1-ene. If you have written as 2-ene, it is wrong. If you have written as 1-2-ene, then also it's wrong. Okay, so double bond definitely belongs to both carbons 1 and 2, but you will not mention both numbers. Among them, the least number you have to mention. So that is where you have to be careful. Okay, so this is what the name of this particular compound. Now let us go for another example. Example number 2. See, these two rules are very, very important. They are common rules, right? Observe this example, CH3, CH double bond, CH2, CH2, CH3. Okay. So, how do you name this compound? So, first thing is selecting a longest chain, isn't it? So, longest chain is definitely your straight chain, right? Okay. So, after selecting a longest chain, you have to give numbering. So, how do you number? Do you go from left to right or right to left? If you go from left to right, what are the numbers you can give? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Isn't it? So, double bond containing carbon is getting number 2. It is getting number 3 also, but consider the lowest number, number 2. If you number from right to left, this carbon is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5. If you come from this end, double bond containing carbon is having number 3. If you go from left to right, double bond containing carbon has a number 2. So, number 2 is least right. So, left to right way of numbering is a correct method. So, numbering is over. Now, writing its name. There are no branches to write as a prefix. So, directly start with a word root. So, what is the word root? It has got 5 carbons, so I can use pent, right? Pent hyphen, see, at both second carbon and third carbon, between them you have double bond. It belongs to both carbons, but two numbers you can't include, only one number. So, select the least number, that is 2. So, pent-2-ene is the name of this compound, right? So, hope the concepts are getting clear for you, right? All that is fine. And now, let me go for the third example. Example number 3. Observe this. CH3, C triple bond, CH2, CH3. So, how about the name of this compound? Similarly, see, you have triple bond here. So, select the longest chain. So, this is our longest chain. And how do you number this? Either from left to right or right to left. Left to right, if I number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right to left, if I number 1, 2, 3. Triple bond containing carbon is having number 3. Whereas when I go from left to right, triple bond containing carbon has got number 2. So this is the correct way of numbering. So then how do you write its name? So, there are no branches, so no prefix here also. Directly start from word root. What is the word root? It is pent hyphen at second carbon, triple bond is there. So, you have to use the primary suffix yne. When triple bond is there, primary suffix is yne. When double bond is there, primary suffix is ene. And don't forget to mention the number of carbon atom to which the double bond is attached. Right? So, this is a very, very basic nomenclature. What if both double and triple bonds are there in a compound? Let's discuss that example. Observe this example. CH triple bond C, CH2, CH double bond CH2. Okay. So, in this example, so this is our example number 4. Every compound that I am writing as example is very important because you are learning one different rule in every example, right? So here, both double and triple bonds are there, right? So I am talking about the rule number 3, okay, with a particular example. So, when both double and triple bonds are there, you have to give more preference for the double bond. Okay. So, preference is for double bond. Remember this, double bond. Okay, so first is what? Selecting a longest chain. Yes, definitely this is our longest chain. And numbering. Numbering is done in such a way that double bond containing carbon should get the least number. Okay, so you are giving more preference to double bond, right? So carbon containing double bond should get least number. Remember, so that is what we mean by giving preference, right? So I will number from this end, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? Hope the point has become clear. Very, very important. When both double bond and triple bonds are there, you know, you should give numbers for carbon atom which has got a double bond, a least number. Okay, so carbon containing double bond should get a least number. So this is what the important thing one must understand. Fine. So we have given numbering. Then our next duty is to write its name. So how do you write? There are no branches, so no prefix to write. Directly start with the word root. What is the word root? 5 carbons in a chain. So word root is pent. After that, first mention double bond, then mention triple bond. Okay, so at which carbon double bond is there? First carbon. So 1 in, again put a hyphen, mention the carbon's number at which triple bond is there. It is 4. You can't mention 5. You have to select the least number among them. That is 4. So at 4th carbon, triple bond is there. So YNE. Right? So this is the name of this particular compound. Pent 1 in 4 Ine, Y-N-E. Okay, so first should be double bond, later should be triple bond while writing a name. Okay, so this is what we mean by giving preference to double bond, right? And now let us check with few more examples. Example number 5. See guys, even in this example, triple bond is there, double bond is there, but double bond is not at the end. It is somewhere in the middle. Triple bond is at end. What is the difference between this example and this example? Here, triple bond was at end, double bond was at end. So while giving numbers, we gave more preference to double bond. So carbon having double bond has got a least number. From this side, I started numbering. Whereas here, if I think that double bond has got more preference, so I should start numbering from this end onwards, right? Say if I have given numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then it is wrong. You can give preference for double bond when that double bond is at end. Okay, but now here double bond is not at end, so you're not supposed to give numbers this way. So what we have to do here, we have to follow lowest locant rule. Lowest locant rule. Okay, so everybody must have been aware of lowest locant rule, right? So what will I do? Imagine I have given numbers from this end. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So what is the lowest locant? Say triple bond containing carbon has got number 1. Number 1 plus double bond containing carbon has got number 3. Least numbers. You can tell that this triple bond is there for carbon 2 also. So can't I take 2 here? No, you have to take only one number. That is the least number. So I took 1 because triple bond is there at 1. 3 because double bond is there at 3. So 1 plus 3, you will get 4. But if I number from this end, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then what do I get? Double bond containing carbon has got number 2 plus triple bond containing carbon has got number 4. So you will get the lowest locant 6. Right? So which is the least number? Definitely 4 is the least number. So which way of numbering is correct? you know, left to right numbering. This is left to right numbering. This is right to left numbering. So left to right numbering is correct here. Okay, so this is the correct way of numbering. It's not that now I have given more preference to triple bond. Okay, see, it is that I follow the lowest locant rule here. Okay, see, when you have to give preference to the double bond for numbering, when both triple bond and double bond is at end, corner carbons, then you will get a dilemma from which end you have to start numbering, right? Then start numbering from double bond side. But here, double bond is somewhere in the middle, triple bond is also there, okay? So then you can't start numbering from this end. You have to check the lowest locant and then number it, right? So now numbering is over, writing its name. How do you write its name? There is no branch to write as a prefix. So directly I'll start with a word root. What is a word root here? Word root is pent, right? Then you have to mention the position of double bond, later the position of triple bond. Always follow this, okay? So when you write a primary suffix, position of double bond you mention first and later position of triple bond. Okay, so where is our double bond present? It is present at third carbon. So I'll write 3-ene. And where is our triple bond present? It is at first carbon. So 1-yne. So this is the name of this compound. Pent 3-ene-1-yne. Right? Okay. So now observe this example. So here we have two double bonds, right? So two double bonds, and how do you start numbering here? Yes, definitely our straight chain is this. Straight chain must include the double bonds. So this is our straight chain. So now this has become our branch, isn't it? The thing is, from which side you will start numbering is a big question mark. Will you start numbering from left to right or right to left? See, even left side, leftmost carbon has got a double bond. Rightmost carbon has also got double bond, right? So you can't number however you want. Check the branch. See that branch also should get least number, right? So if you go from left to right, say if I number this carbon as 1, this as 2, this as 3 and this as 4. See, double bond containing carbon is getting number 1. Branch containing carbon is getting number 2. Even this is least. But when you go from right to left, double bond containing carbon will have number 1. Whereas branch containing carbon is getting number 3. 2 is more or 3 is more? 3 is more. 2 is least. So least one you have to follow, right? So left to right way of numbering is always correct. Okay, you have to see that double bond should get least number, and you must also see that if branch is there, branch containing carbon also should get a least number. First preference is double bond only, but okay, if branch is there, see that branch also should have some value. Okay, fine. So this is the correct way of numbering. Now writing its name. Branch is there. We have something to write for the prefix. So what is the prefix? Methyl. Which methyl? 2-methyl. It is 2-methyl. Prefix is over. Now word root. What is the word root? 4 carbons in a chain. So bute. Right. So bute hyphen. And where are the double bonds? 2 double bonds are present. Okay, and what are their positions? 1, 1, 3. Okay, you have to, 3, 4 is there, but you have to take the least number. Okay, so 1, 3, diene. Okay, clear? So 1, 3, diene you have to mention. And now, so when you mention something like diene, triene, etc., here A should come, not just bute. You have to write it as buta. Okay, why I have added A here? When you have like diene, triene, you know, this di, tri, tetra, these prefixes when you introduce, then here A must be there. Okay, so what is its name? 2-methyl-buta-1,3-diene. Right, so that is what the name of this compound. And coming to our next example. right? Fine. So how do you number this? You see, triple bond is there, double bond is there, double bond is there at the end carbon, right? So definitely straight chain is this only. Numbering you will start from this end. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? Fine. So now writing a name, 6 carbons in a chain. So you will use the word root hex. Okay, so hex hyphen, first you mention the double bond's name. Where are the double bonds present? One and one more double bond at third carbon. 1,3-diene. Again hyphen. Mention the position of triple bond. 5. Okay, not 6. 5. Least number you have to take. 5. Y-N-E. And why did I leave a gap here? Diene has come. So it is hexa. A must be added there. Hexa 1,3-diene 5 Y-N-E. Okay, so that is the name of this compound. So I think I have covered all the rules with these examples. Now let us work with few more examples, and for some examples you are posting answers in a comment section. See guys, I represented structures in bond line representation, right? So how do you name this? So bond line representation is quite easy. Think that everywhere carbons are there. Carbon. At every point carbons are there, right? So this is CH carbon, this is CH, this is CH, right? So this is CH2 and this one is CH2. So this is our normal structure. So now it's actually a linear structure. Say one, there are no branches here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right? So 8 carbons are there. And this is your longest chain. And how do you number this? You can number in any ways because alternative double bonds are there. So let me number from this end. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Isn't it? Okay. So writing its name. See, our main chain has got 8 carbons. So I can write it as octa. I have written A here because, you know, more than one double bonds are there. So I have written A here. Hyphen. Mention the numbers at number 1 carbon double bond. At number 3 is a double bond. And at number 5 is a double bond. And at number 7 is a double bond. So octa 1, 3, 5, 7 tetraene. Tetraene. Okay, so this is how you have to name them. So very, very important and very simple example actually. So you don't expect in a normal format. See, they may ask you the names of a compound giving bond line representation. Okay, fine. Now observe second example, guys. Double bond is there, triple bond is there, branch is there, isn't it? So how do you select a longest chain? Longest chain is a straight chain. If I have to write its normal structure, it is CH3. Then at C you have BR and you have a double bond, and this is another carbon CH, and this is CH2, and this is C, triple bond CH. So this is normal pattern of writing a compound. And now giving a numbering for carbon atoms. So should I give numbers from left to right or right to left? It is from left to right. It is because you see, if you go from left, second carbon has double bond and second carbon has BR. So this carbon should get more preference. So this carbon should have a least number. It has double bond and it has branch also, right? So we are numbering from this end. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Even if you check lowest to locant, you know, this one, left to right locant is lowest. Okay, fine. Now leftover thing is we have to write its name. What is the branch? BR. What is its name? Bromo. To which carbon it is attached? 2. So it is 2-bromo. Prefix is over. Writing a word root. What is a word root? 6 carbons. So it is hex hyphen. First mention double bond. That is, double bond is at second carbon, so 2-ene. Later mentioned triple bond, 5-yne. So this is the name of this particular compound. Okay. And now coming to your homework question. So this is your homework question and you are giving answer for this question in a comment section. Right. So with this, I have completed all the points on the nomenclature of unsaturated hydrocarbons. So any unsaturated hydrocarbon can be answered very, very easily after learning all these rules. Very nice. And coming to our next video, I will discuss about the most important type of organic compounds, nomenclature of organic compounds with functional groups. Okay, so here we will learn n number of examples and too many rules to remember. And when you practice with more examples, you will become perfect and you will get that confidence. So don't miss it out. My next video, it is going to be a very, very important and interesting video, that is nomenclature of organic compounds with functional groups. So take care. Have a quick revisions, and consistent revisions are very, very important in case of organic chemistry. Generally, we say organic compounds are volatile. Volatile in the sense they escape very easily. Just like organic compounds, study of organic chemistry is also volatile. If you don't revise, they can easily escape from your head. If you don't want them to get escaped into, escaped out of the head, you have to hold them very tightly. You should keep them in your mind by doing continuous revisions and continuous practice, right? So that's all I wanted to tell you. Keep learning and take care. Meet you all in the next video. Thank you so much.